It's the monthly meeting of the Greensburg Board of Aviation Commissioners. I've asked Andrew and Jerry if they can go ahead and sit with us. We got pushed into this room, so we'll all sit here together at the table. But roll call, Judy.
Bill Orsis?
Here.
Orson Reeves?
Here.
Don Wood?
Here. Jim Brew? Jim Brew?
Jim Brew, yes.
All right, so we have 4 out of 5 here. That's a quorum. First, we'll take a look at the agenda. I just have, compared to what we've been having, it's a rather limited agenda here tonight. Everybody will take a look at it. Does anybody else have anything to add or amend on the agenda?
I move we accept it.
Change my name.
Sorry.
Oh, yes. Yeah, the only thing we'll do is...
Andrew M.
Yeah, Andrew Maximovich instead of Paul Schaefer, who's in BF&S tonight.
I saved it.
So we have a first from Morris, second from Bill. All in favor of accepting this amended agenda, say aye.
Aye.
Okay. It's approved as amended. We have the minutes from the September 26th meeting. We have those all emailed to us. You know, we do have a rather short meeting, so I'll tell you what I'll do is I'll have Judy go ahead and read them this time. You have a copy here? Here, I have a copy.
City of Greensburg, Indiana, Board of Aviation Commissioners, Monday, September the 26th, 2016. Call to order. President John Dooley called the meeting to order at 7 p.m. Board members present were John Dooley, Bill Ernstis, Don Whipple, Horace Reese, and Jim Pruitt. Jerry Scheidler, airport manager, and Corey Harper, BF&S airport planner, were also present. Paul Schaefer, BF&S, and Mayor Ned Menace were absent. Judy Kirk performed the duties of secretary. The meeting agenda was reviewed. Bill Ernstis asked that the topic fire extinguishers be added to the agenda under new business. A motion was made by Horace Reese and seconded by Bill Ernstis to approve the agenda as amended. The motion passed unanimously by voice vote 5-0. John Dooley noted that the agenda was very full and suggested that the minutes be approved as published to save time. A motion was made by Don Whipple to approve the August 22nd, 2016 regular meeting minutes as published. Jim Pruitt seconded the motion. The motion passed unanimously by voice vote 5-0. Financial report. Bill Ernstis read the financial report. Old business. Corey Harper reported that Dave O'Meara Contracting has completed the seal coating on the ramp and has complied with the specs. He recommended that the board have the condition of the ramp rechecked after the winter cycle to make sure the seal coating has performed as specified. 2017 airport budget. John Dooley asked for discussion on the 2017 budget. Don Whipple noted that the budget was advertised in a legal ad and is okay as presented. After discussion, Jim Pruitt made a motion to approve the 2017 budget as presented. Board's re-seconded the motion. The motion passed unanimously by roll call vote 5-0. Interest on deposit use of funds. John Dooley noted that the board has the authority to decide where to put BOAC funds. The city clerk does the accounting function for the board. BOAC funds are currently held in a main source account at 0.25%. After discussion of various investment options, the board took no action. The topic was tabled and will be added to the January 2017 agenda for review. New business. Fire extinguisher update. Billers has reported that Crossman had notified him that the fire extinguisher for the fuel pumping system is insufficient and needs to be replaced. Crossman recommended a 20-pound high-flow purple Buckeye fire extinguisher and a new plastic cabinet. The cost would be $285 for the extinguisher and $145.85 for the cabinet. The motion was made by Jim Pruitt to purchase the new fire extinguisher and cabin for a total of $430.85. Horace Reese seconded the motion. The motion passed unanimously by voice vote 5-0. Courtesy car for airport. Discussion. John Dooley offered the board some information for discussion regarding purchasing a courtesy car for the airport. Jeremy Scheidler noted that he receives a request for transportation approximately every 2 to 3 weeks. The topic was tabled. Surface of taxiway near the east side of Hangar G and south of Hangar E discussion. John Dooley reported that the taxi lane near the east side of Hangar G and south of Hangar E was in poor condition. Billers has added that the project cost would be an estimated $43,889. Corey Harper suggested that the resurfacing project be added to the CIP and that the project may be eligible for FAA funding. The project would require that the old asphalt be removed and dirt compacted. It would also require 6 layers of stone, 4 layers of asphalt, and would need to be a uniform 20 feet wide. Approval of bills. The bills were prepared for approval or Shoesman a motion to pay the bills as listed. Jim Pruitt seconded the motion. The motion passed unanimously by roll call vote 5-0. Comments from the board and or public. Bill Rinses noted that a Bell Ranger helicopter with a bucket refueled at the airport has been hired by local farmers to sow rye in fields. The same helicopter has been used to fight forest fires. Meeting adjournment and next meeting date. There will be no further business before the board. Don Whipple made a motion and Bill Rinses seconded the motion to adjourn the meeting. The motion passed unanimously by voice vote 5-0. And President John Dooley adjourned the meeting at 7:40 p.m. The next meeting will be held on Monday, October 24th, at City Hall at 7 p.m.
Okay, those are our minutes from the last month's reading. Any discussion about the minutes? If not, I'll entertain a motion to accept. Israel, moved by Don, seconded by Bill. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Passes 4-0. Voice vote. Next on the agenda, our financial report. Bill, if you'll read finances.
Airport Improvement Fund, $32,708.86. Refuel Fund, $69,109.73. Airport Operation Fund, $174,182.60 for a grand total of $276,001.18.
Okay. That's our financial report. Under old business, I don't know if there's anything to make a motion on here. Just last, as it said in the minutes, as you'll recall from last month, we talked about the taxiway by Hangar G and south of Hangar E. We were discussing that. If anybody had a chance to go out there and take a look at it, Donald?
I did. I drove out there and looked it over, and it has been some improvement.
Yeah.
I would suggest wait for next spring, maybe.
They had suggested what Corey Harper had suggested, we wait and put it on the CIP.
Yeah.
So we get some, he said some of it, not all, and they'd be reimbursable. So I think you got to do that. Yeah. I don't know when the CIP comes up again. It comes up to
due
February 1st. So we'll be talking about it pretty soon.
Okay.
We'll have to read.
John, in the minutes that she talked about the forest acres, has that work been done?
Yep, today.
Okay.
That's today.
Okay. Yeah, of course, no, we don't have to make any motions or anything, but is it the board's feeling we'll wait until we get that on the CIP so we can reimburse?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So we'll table that until that time when the CIP comes up. Okay. All right. We'll go under new business. We've got Andrew Maximovich today with us from BF&S. Paul couldn't be with us today. So thanks for being with us, Andrew. Appreciate it.
Sure. And I brought with me two things. Both of them are somewhat related, but if you will, I would suggest that you entertain that closeout for the taxiway preservation overlay grant that was just completed. Grant was sealed. We just spent all the time looking at it. I got the final pay request. I got the final contract documents. The final pay request will have one last draw of FAA dollars, and that is federal reimbursement on them for $21,600. We got $1,200 from the state on them.
So,
second. Federal is $21,600. State reimbursement.
discussion, Bill moves that we sign those documents for reimbursement. Otherwise, any other discussion? Or seconds, any other further discussion? If not, we'll just take a voice vote on signing those documents. Judy? A roll call, yes. You know what I meant.
Is that right? Bill Ordis?
Yes.
Forrest Reed?
Yeah.
Don Whipple?
Yes.
Don Dooley?
Yes. So I'll sign those before Andrew takes off right here. Anything else from BF&S, Andrew?
That's the only comment I've got.
Okay.
All I wanted to ask one, and he's still having a private meeting with the FAA.
Yeah. All right, then it comes to our bills. We all got the, you all got the bills in the email. And then we got action the day after that she sent us one more bill from Dr. Trigger.
One more, but I didn't.
Did you get the other ones?
Did I?
It's in your documents there, if you take a look. The ones we gave you here?
No.
Okay. I've got copies up here, there are copies you can get. I got mine through the email, you're not getting your email, sir?
Didn't get that one, I got the additional.
Yeah, I printed this out from the email we got. Did you get, are you getting your emails? Okay. Short list of bills. We got.
They were
pass that down to Don right there.
Well, yeah, that's a real problem.
The first one had four bills on it. One was for sales tax, operating supplies, utility service, and operating supplies for a total of $594.04. And then trip is $1,011 on that.
Yeah, so for his 3 months, he itemized what he had on that.
I'm going to say the same thing I did 3 months ago. Why does he wait to the last minute when he knows when he wants?
I don't know.
The last meeting, if you remember, I made a motion that we did not pay it until the next month. I'm not going to do that this time.
Yeah, he did.
But I still feel the same way.
Just before the meeting, though. I mean, he got it through some time.
That's not the point.
Yeah. Don?
I'm going to pay the bills.
Got a motion? Motion to pay. Any other discussion before we, or is motions we second with stipulations, so.
But the next time that he does that, I'm gonna make a motion that we not pay it. I'm gonna tell you straight up front.
I'll be talking to his viewers,
Okay, voice vote, Judy, please, on paying new bills, including the Mr. Trigger's bill. Roll call vote. We need a new president. That's right, roll call vote, please.
Billers?
Yes.
Forrest Reed?
Yeah.
Donovan?
Yes.
Yes. Like I said, we have a rather short agenda here tonight, unusually short. Comments from anybody on the board, Don?
I would like to make a comment.
Yes.
I like this configuration many times better than the one with the council. Is there any reason why we can't meet here?
I don't think there's any reason to be up to the board if they want to do that. I know they like, it's not required, but they do like the recordings, right? They like the microphone recordings. They're not required, but they're desired to have the microphone recordings public.
The only problem with that over there is you guys on the other side of the room are so far apart.
I agree. I like this format myself.
So it is.
Maybe we'll talk about that and see what do you think that works.
I agree with you.
At the round table.
Yeah. Especially when
I don't know if there's a way we can get the recording in this in here or not, that would be
well, first of all, I don't hear the when we're over there and we're speaking, Andrew talking when he talked, I wouldn't have heard a thing that he said if I was sitting. Not a guest board, you were saying.
It was all good.
Good.
It was all good.
I heard it. It was okay.
I kind of like the format myself, if we can figure out a way to.
These tables in.
Well, that's not going to be able to, because then they might put another armament for the set.
Yeah, that one.
Yeah.
That one, I was able to get a digital recorder, but it had a microphone that covered everybody.
Yeah.
He set that out there for 6 hours in the morning.
There is a way to do it, when you start to see it.
It has to be downloadable.
We did this, we want to speak, we don't have an audience tonight, we've got you. We'd like to say loud if we're, any audience could hear us too, so.
I don't know how the audience could hear someone standing in front of a microphone. When I've been to that meetings in that room, in the audience, I don't hear.
Those speakers.
If they speak in the microphone, I can hear it pretty well. If they're in the podium, you mean? I can usually hear it pretty well.
Those speakers in the field.
What's the difference?
I know, I'm still. Well, it's like the round table. I think that.
Yeah. Well, maybe think about that or explore that, I like the idea too, so. Any other comments from anybody? Special one from the public, anybody? If not, that concludes our meeting, I've got us here at 7:20, stretched it out to that. We'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Bill and Don, first and second, all in favor to adjourn, say aye.
Aye.
Okay, I've got things for you to sign over here, guys, so.